So I did a whole series of teepee installations but around campus, kind of like an ode to my ancestors, and to kind of let people know, you know, this was native lands. And then after that, I applied to UCLA, and I got in, and that was another transition. Everyone there had libraries in their studios full of contemporary artists who I've never heard of, because we only studied like ancient medieval art and art history at Montana State University. Give me that love I'll be waiting
for, yeah. Experience that I've got both times going there is a real sense of feeling refreshed and renewed and inspired. Always reflecting back on home and my community at home, I miss it a lot. And I don't live on my reservation anymore. I live in Portland, Oregon. And to be located on that reservation reminds me of being home very much. And so that's another source of feeling supported and comforted, and that's very rare. So in that way, they've impacted me greatly, and I hope that I can pay back, you know, what they've provided for me. I am half white. My mother's white. She grew up out of Colorado. So growing up, a lot of our family time, we'd go for vacations to Colorado. So I grew up knowing what it was like off the reservation, but it wasn't until I moved into my own independence as a young adult going to undergrad that I really started to see a stark contrast between the way I grew up and outside of the reservation. And some of the things that I noticed was just a lot of the cultural differences between community, also lower economic situations such as income and poverty and access to good food and those sort of things. So I was really kind of using those as points of reference to see some of the contrast that I was experiencing. Because I draw so much from my experience growing up on the Crow Reservation, it's really important for me that everyone knows that all of my work is really about my experience growing up and being immersed in the Crow community. So I feel like with my work, which is just sort of stating these facts that people don't know about, and then they might feel that tension or that friction that's running up into that colonial wall. And so I guess that could be looked at as activism and stuff like that, but for me it's just pointing out another truth. For me, I think once a work is made, that if my audience, if they experience it to the point where it makes them want to question things, I feel like it's a successful piece of work. And then now I feel like I've moved away from that a bit, and the focus is more on showing people that aren't Crow or haven't grown up in that community, pointing towards humanism and humanity, and that can connect everyone. I work from a place of honesty and truth for myself, and it might not be other people's truth or experience, but it's so important for me to be honest and truthful in what I do.